I'm Bob at I Like to Make Stuff. Today I'm going to show you how I made this four-player quiz game. From another project, I had several strips of excess plywood, so I ripped them down into 4.5-inch strips. Then I held those strips up against the blade and set my stop block. This way, I could cut them down into perfect squares. Once I had a bunch of those cut, I took three of them and glued them together, not along the inside, but just around the outside. Then I added some clamps to hold it together while the glue set up. After the glue had dried, I took it to the bandsaw and cut out the middle of the box. Now this is kind of like you would do if you were making a bandsaw box. I went in from one side and cut out a section in the middle. I added some glue to the section that I'd cut out and clamped it back up to dry. I made four of those in total, one for each player. And each one of these had a top panel where I marked the center point before gluing and clamping it on. After they all dried, I used a Forstner bit, a 1 1/8-inch bit, to drill a hole at the center point of each one of the boxes. This is just big enough for an arcade button to drop in. For each one of these, I took another panel and countersunk some holes into each corner. I screwed these onto the bottom of the box to make a solid box. After each box had a bottom, I took all of them to the disc sander. This took a little while, but I squared off all six faces on all four boxes. Then I took each one to the belt sander, and this helped me make a roundover on all of the corners. It's not entirely necessary, but it was a nice feature since these are going to be held by kids. I rounded over as much as I could, but even in the corners, they were still a little sharp, so I used an orbital sander to knock those down and kind of finish everything up. For the control box, I cut down some more plywood to the same width, but then cut it twice as long to make a rectangle instead of a square. Followed the exact same process for all of the other stuff to end up with just a larger version of the same box. Once they were all sanded, I sprayed a few coats of spray lacquer on all of them. Each one of these arcade buttons has five terminals on it, but we only really care about four of them. Two are for the LED, two are for the button itself. Since each one of these has four wires coming off of it, I'm going to use a phone cable because it's four conductor, all in one piece of insulation. I cut the end off of a cheap phone cable and then stripped off some of the outside insulation, being sure not to strip off the insulation from the inner wires. I cut four sections of this wire, and then I had to strip each one of the inner wires on both ends in each cable. This is the wiring setup for a single button, just so it's easier to see what's going on. You start with an Arduino Uno that has 5 volts and ground going to a perf board. Then I have the arcade button with the four wires connected, and they go also to the perf board. There are two resistors in play here, one for the LED and one for the button. Both of those have a line that go to a pin on the Arduino. And this is what it looks like on the bottom. I added all the other buttons in the exact same way, and it's messy to look at, but they're all the same, just spaced out across the board. When I unscrewed the bottom of the boxes, I made sure to mark one side so I knew which direction to put them back on, and then I dropped in the buttons and screwed them on with the nut that comes with them. The wire needed to go through the box, so I marked a small area and cut out just enough area for the wire to fit through. I twisted the LED and the button into the button housing, and then super glued in the wire into the slot. I tried hot glue as well, but super glue worked much better. I gave it a test and then did the same for all of the other buttons. The only difference for the control box was that there were four wires coming in and I had to cut slots for each one of them. I added in a single reset button to this box, but it doesn't use the LED. I mounted the perf board and the Arduino to the top of the inside of this box with a screw each. Then I chiseled out a small area for a power cord to fit through and glued it in place. I also glued in the four cords coming out to each one of the controllers. To prevent any of the wires from falling out of the Arduino since it was upside down, I added some hot glue to all the wires to kind of lock them together. This also acts as an insulator just in case. I used it just to hold wires in place inside the box and then screwed the bottom on. Then it was done. I made sure to test all the buttons to make sure that everything worked before taking it to the kids to see if they liked it. The first button that gets pressed lights up, and once one is lit up, none of the other ones will light up until I hit the reset button. That way we know who is the first person to answer.
A mallard duck?
Yeah,
you got it. A male.
Grizzly bear?
Yep, there's a grizzly bear.
Yeah! A white chicken?
Yes!
Hey!
Really quickly, I gotta tell you about something that's coming up over the next couple of months. I got asked by a company called Quarterly to curate the next MakerBox. Basically, every 3 months, they send out a MakerBox with a bunch of cool stuff, and in this case, I get to pick out what goes in the box. I can't tell you what's in the box, but if you know me, you will get a pretty good idea of the type of thing that I will put in that box. Basically, you just subscribe to the box. When it ships in May of this year, they will send it to you, and you get a bunch of cool stuff to work on. It's all stuff that you can do with your your hands, things that you can actually make, and there's gonna be a note inside from me explaining kind of what's in there. So be sure to go check out Quarterly if you're interested and subscribe for the Maker Box. I'd love to know what you think about this one. You can let me know in the comments below or my website, ILikeToMakeStuff.com. Also on the website, I've got articles and videos for everything that I've ever done, as well as a bunch of plans that you can buy and t-shirts and all sorts of stuff. Be sure to check out the website. I've also got social links down here and lots more videos for you to check out. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.